Good afternoon, student. This is our third lecture on descriptive statistics. The today's topic is histogram, ogive curve, and stem and leaf chart. So we start with our lecture. Graphical presentation. Now in this lecture, we cover these three diagrams, that is histogram, ogive curve, that is cumulative frequency curve, and third, stem and leaf chart. So we first start with histogram. So what is histogram and why we require histogram? So see, it is popularly used graph for representation of frequency distribution. In previous lecture, we already saw what is the frequency distribution. It is a table containing classes along with frequency. That means, see this example. This is the age group and this is population. So age group is nothing but what? Classes. And population is nothing but frequency. So this whole table is called as frequency distribution. To represent this frequency distribution in terms of diagram, we required histogram. To draw histogram, what we required? We required mid values on x-axis and frequency on y-axis. What is mid value? The middlemost value of the classes. So what is middlemost value of this first class? 5, second 15, third 25, 35, 45, and 55. All are what? Mid values of these classes. And population is frequency. So see here. Here we consider age group on x-axis and population on, that is frequency on, y-axis. For age group 5 to 10, what is your population? That is 500. So for age group 0 to 10, my population is what? 500. For age group 10 to 20, population is 2100. The age group 10 to 20, population is 2100. For 20 to 30, it is 2200. And the last, for age group 50 to 60, population is 400. In this way, we draw a histogram. So only remember one thing, the histogram is a simple the representation of frequency distribution. Next, ogive curve or cumulative frequency curve. So there are two types of cumulative frequency curve. Based on this, there are two types of cumulative frequency curves. Okay, so first is what? Less than cumulative frequency curve, and second, more than cumulative frequency curve. So we will first start with less than cumulative frequency curve. For less than cumulative frequency curve, we required, what we required? Upper boundaries of classes on x-axis and less than cumulative frequency on y-axis. So for the data, we have to first calculate these two values, that is upper boundaries and less than cumulative frequency. In previous lecture, we already saw how to find less than cumulative frequency. I will repeat it again. So what is my question? Draw less than cumulative frequency curve for the following data. So this is my data. Marks and number of students. So solution. Next, we have to first find less than cumulative frequency. So how to find? It is obtained from frequency. And what is frequency here? Frequency is nothing but the number of students. So first frequency as it is, that is 5. Then addition of first 2, 17, addition of first 3, that is 60, addition of first 4, that is 92, and addition of first 5, that is 100. I will repeat it again. The first value as it is, addition of first 2, I will get 17. Addition of first 3, 60. Addition of first 4, 92. And addition of first 5, that is 100. Now next, what I required? The upper boundaries. These are the my classes. 40 to 50, 50 to 60, and last 80 to 90. So for 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90, all are what? Upper boundaries. While 40, 50, 60, 70, and 80, all are called as lower boundaries. So now for this data, for LCF and for upper boundaries, we plot less than cumulative frequency curve. So see here, this is my LCF. LCF stand for less than cumulative frequency, and UB stand for upper boundary. Now how to plot here? See, on x-axis we take upper boundaries, and on y-axis we take LCF. So my upper boundary is what? That is 50. For that upper boundary, my LCF is what? 5. So see, for 50, first give 1 point here. Next value is 60, for that LCF is 70. So next value is 60, LCF is 70. For 70, it is 60. For upper boundary 80, it is 92. And for 90, it is what? 100. Now give 1 point and then join this point by straight line. So you will get LCF curve, that is less than cumulative frequency curve. Always remember, the less than cumulative frequency curve is always in increasing order. Okay, now next we go for more than cumulative frequency curve. So see, for more than cumulative frequency curve, we required lower boundaries on x-axis and more than cumulative frequency on y-axis. Now see here, we required opposite value. That is, for more than cumulative frequency, we required lower boundary, and for less than cumulative frequency, we required upper boundary. Okay. Now again, for the same question, we have to draw more than cumulative frequency curve. For that, we require two values, that is MCF and lower limit or lower boundary. So how to find MCF? Again, it is find from MCF. I will show you how to find 8 as it is. Addition of 8 and 32, that is 40. Addition of 8, 32, 43, 83. Addition of this 4, 95. And addition of 5 observation, that is 100. I will repeat it again. 8 as it is, 8 plus 32, that is 40. 8 plus 32 plus 43, that is 83. 8 plus 32 plus 43 plus 12, 95. And all addition of all these 5 number, it is nothing but 100. And what is lower limit? 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, that are lower limit. Now how to plot? See, this is MCF, this is lower limit. We take lower limit on x-axis and MCF on y-axis. For lower limit 40, what is my MCF? 100. For lower limit 40, my MCF is 100. For 50, it is 95. For 60, it is 83. For 70, it is 40. And for 80, it is 8. Now join all these points using straight line. Now here diagram is incomplete, because we have to join this line to y-axis. So from this point, I will exceed this line to here. So this is my complete diagram. and frequency of this point is what? That is zero. More than cumulative frequency is always in decreasing order. Less than, it is increasing order, while more than, decreasing order. For more than, we required MCF on x-axis and lower limit on y-axis. For less than cumulative frequency, we required LCF on x-axis while upper limit on y-axis. Now next, stem and leaf chart. This chart is similar to histogram and it is another presentation of representing the frequency distribution. So how to plot this diagram? So see, consider one example. The following are the marks obtained by 40 students is in class. So these are the marks which is obtained by all the 40 students. So 31 is marks obtained by first student, 37 is marks obtained by second student, and so on. 49 is mark obtained by the last student. Now before we go for procedure of stem and leaf chart, first to plot this chart we have to find the minimum and maximum number from this data. So which is my minimum number? That is smallest number 2, and my highest number is nothing but, see here, what is my highest number is 50. So 02 is my smallest number while 50 is my highest number. Now remember these two number. Now see here, the marks are 2-digit ranging from the minimum 02 and maximum 50. Now this is the most important statement. The unit place are treated as stem. Okay, and so see here, what it is written, unit place is treated as stem. So what is unit place? 0 and 5 is nothing but stem, while 2 and 0 is nothing but leaf value. For example, see here, the 36 has stem 3 while leaf 6. So we make two columns, first one for stem and second one for leaves. Okay, so stem and leaf, how to represent? We have to make two columns. First column is stem and second column is leaf. What is stem? So see here, instead of class interval, we write stem, and instead of telemarks, we go for leaves. For example, consider my first row, that is 31. That is my first number. We select 3 as a stem and I write 1 in the column of leaf. My second number 3 is nothing but stem, while 7 is nothing but leaf. And we continue this way with all the 40 students. So how to make two columns? I will just show you. Here we require two columns. First one is stem and second one is leaf. So my first number is 331. So 3 as a stem and 1 as a leaf. Again second is 37. So I write stem as it is and in front of leaf I write 7. Next 02. So I write 0 as a stem and 2 as a leaf. Next 41. So 4 as a stem and 1 as a leaf. Similarly 12. 1 as a stem and 2 as a leaf. Next 38. Now 3 is already present. So again I write only 8 as a leaf. Next 29. So 2 as a stem and 9 as a leaf. and we continue this procedure. So finally, what I get? So see here, now I write steam in increasing order. So what I get? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now why I write 5? Because 50 is nothing but my highest number and 0, 2 is nothing but my lowest number. So I have to write all the numbers between 0 to 5. So I start with 0 and last is 5. So these are the stem and all R is nothing but leaf. If you count this number, all these number, I get totally marks of all the 40 students. Now my next question is, which stem has maximum leaves? So answer of that question is what? The stem 3 has maximum number of leaf. So this is nothing but the representation of stem and leaf diagram. Thank you.